Baseball. And if you just joined us, wow. Tampa Bay down 7-0, gets 6 in the game, 1 in the ninth on a 2-out pinch hit home run by Dan Johnson to keep their season alive. And now they turn to their closer, former Yankee great Kyle Farnsworth.
Well, Kyle Farnsworth has been an absolute godsend for the Tampa Bay Rays, because coming out of spring training, they didn't have a closer. They were hoping that J.P. Howe would come back sometime in May or June. Maybe he could assume the closer role. But Kyle Farnsworth has stepped up and has done a pretty remarkable job for this team.
He has not allowed a base runner over his last three appearances. 25 saves, a career high, 10th in the American League. And clearly, well, this is not a save situation. This is a just keep that 7 in the Yankee column here situation. Top 10 here. Chavez. Swing and a miss. If you're in a Yankee uniform, chances are pretty good that you've seen action tonight. Well, 11 pitchers.
There's more to come because Jorge Posada's on deck. A-Rod might get an at-bat before this one's over.
He was a late scratch. Chavez, 0-2. What makes Farnsworth difficult to deal with?
Well, the velocity, his size, the fact that he'll throw a slider anytime in the count, sometimes inexplicably why he would throw a slider in certain counts, but and that's been his downfall also, because sometimes he falls in love with the slider. But you know, his velocity is tremendous and he's a great competitor.
Chavez looks at strike three. Good morning, good afternoon, good night.
Well, this is the hardest thing when you're a veteran player of the Yankees. You're just waiting for the postseason to start.
You mean like this guy?
Yeah, you know, you're either up there for one thing. You're going to try to hit a home run to win the game, or after a while, it's just, you know, what am I doing here?
Jorge Posada will pinch hit here in the Yankee 10th.
Hey, it's been a tough year for Jorge. You know, a great veteran, you know, multiple world championship winner for the New York Yankees, and just, you know, a very disappointing season for him. But you know, it's like Bobby Valentine says, you talk to Buck Showalter, he'll still catch up to a fastball.
Swing and a miss there.
That was a slider.
Well, the Yankees have said there's no situation in which they see Jesus Montero not being on the postseason roster. So where that leaves Posada is a judgment call.
Well, depending on the injury to him tonight. I mean,
sure.
he did get hurt, so he had to leave the game. So that's an interesting thing. But yeah, I mean, what do you do with Jorge Posada? If he's not going to be your DH, he's not going to catch, of course. You know, what do you do?
Posada looks at a strike, and Farnsworth, you can't get more efficient than this. He's ahead 0-2.
Well, that's the scouting report, and that's just experience knowing Jorge Posada's been around forever. I mean, you just don't throw him a fastball, and hopefully he chases, which he did the first pitch. Then you continue to throw him off speed stuff until he starts looking for it.
Posada pinch hitting here in the cleanup spot. Joe West did not give him the call, and Farnsworth puts it at 1-2. Orioles and the Red Sox, John Crook, have resumed in Baltimore. The Red Sox lead 3-2.
And the Phillies and the Braves are in extra innings, and they just looked up on the board and saw that the Cardinals have finished off the Astros 8-0, knowing now that the Braves have to win in order to continue their season.
Swing and a miss. Posada strikes out.
Tell you also about Kyle Farnsworth, his confidence. When you have confidence in him and you show confidence in him, and Joe Maddon to me is one of the best at giving guys that confidence. Dusty Baker was another one that gave him confidence in Chicago. That, you know, you tell him how good he is and you tell him you can do this and you can be the closer, you know, or our ninth inning guy, as Joe Maddon wants to put it, not terming the closer. Kyle Farnsworth can relax and throw it.
Here's Chris Dickerson. Misses away 1-0.
Looks like too he's come up with that little two seamer too that he didn't have in the past, with running away from those left hand hitters to give him another weapon.
As we've mentioned, the Yankees have used 11 pitchers tonight, and you know, if this thing goes a little while longer, that might become an issue. I know they got about 100 guys down there, but 3-0.
And that's the thing with Farnsworth. He gets two veteran hitters in Chavez and Posada, makes them both look pretty foolish. And he gets Dickerson up here, younger player, still some experience, and can't find the strike zone.
That's remarkable. Farnsworth comes in and blows away the first two hitters, then walks Chris Dickerson on four pitches.
And four pitches, and weren't really that close. You know, and Dickerson can run a little bit. Now you have Gardner, who's a pesky little slap hitter. You know, if Dickerson can steal second base, and, you know, you're asking for trouble.
So here's Brett Gardner. Two outs, top 10. The Yankees had a 7-0 lead. The Rays got six in the eighth, one in the ninth, and here we are. Dickerson to bank. I think Kyle Farnsworth, Drucky, was thinking what you were thinking, that Dickerson can run a little bit there. Keep an eye on him.
Yeah, you know, Dickerson's a guy too. He wants to prove to people he can play, be a big league player. And, you know, okay, walk me up. Now I can steal a base and become a threat. Even if I don't hit to get on, if I walk to get on, I'm going to be a threat.
Got a pretty healthy lead, but he stays put. Now Lobaton will go out there and talk to Kyle Farnsworth. Cardinals win in Houston. Phillies and Braves tied up in Atlanta. Red Sox lead in Baltimore. We are tied here, Yankees and Rays in St. Pete. Farnsworth keeping a close eye on Chris Dickerson over there at first with two outs.
Yeah, and that's the thing. That's the thing that's really bothersome to a manager. There's two outs. You've just thrown five consecutive balls. Let's get the hitter. Look, if you get Brett Gardner out, he can steal second. Dickerson can steal second and third without an issue. But, you know, unless this is Farnsworth's way of getting himself back into a rhythm and getting him, you know, to not think about the previous five pitches.
Upton and Longoria scheduled to lead off the Tampa Bay 10th.
Trying to keep him close.
We had a few folks leave when it was 7-0 Yankees, but most of them have hung around here, and boy, they're glad they did. 7-7 top 10. There goes Dickerson. Lobaton, no throw. And the Yankees have the go-ahead run in scoring position here with two outs.
That's a great jump by Dickerson. And the thing is, throw over, and more throw over. But the bottom line is Kyle Farnsworth is slow to home plate because he's a big guy with the leg kick to generate power. And Dickerson was in easy without even a throw. And, you know, if I'm Desmond Jennings in left field and B.J. Upton, I'm moving in shallow to try to cut this run off. You know, if Gardner hits it over your head and he short hops the wall or hits it to the warning track, you tip your hat to it. They're not even going to pitch to him.
And with first base open, they'll walk Gardner. Austin Romine is the Yankees on deck hitter. You like this?
Yes, because, you know, even though Gardner's a relatively young player, he's still an experienced player, where Romine is a young kid. And you saw what happened in a situation with Desmond Jennings. He swung at a bad pitch with the bases loaded because he's young and eager. And that's what they're hoping for here with Romine. You let Gardner get on base. Now you get two outs. You have Romine come up, and hopefully he'll chase a bad pitch in this at bat to get himself out.
So it's first and second, two outs for the Yankees, top 10, and Austin Romine steps in against Kyle Farnsworth. Keep in mind also, they've lost Montero. Posada pinch hit. And now here's Romine.
Russell Martin.
Yep. Romine looks at a strike.
That's a great pitch right there, the 1-0. Get ahead 0-1, because, you know, it's been a struggle for Farnsworth the last couple hitters hitting the strike zone. The thing is, now he can't worry about Dickerson on second. Of course he's not going to worry about Gardner. And his focus is right now, no one on base, two outs. All I need to do is get this guy out and move on and let our power guys come up and try to win it for us.
Romine, 22 years old. He's down 0-1. Foul back. Austin Romine spent most of this season with Double-A Trenton. He hit .286. Six home runs, 47 driven in 85 games. And they are on their feet here with Roman in an 0-2 hole, two outs, top 10. Dickerson at second, Gardner at first. Farnsworth, who began the inning by striking out two Yankee hitters, has walked two, one intentionally, and now is ahead here on Austin Roman, 0-2. Struck him out. Ring him up, sit him down, says Joe West. They're on their feet here at the Trop. We're going bottom 10. Here come the Rays. You'll see Upton and Longoria, 7-7, bottom 10 at the Trop. We are rocking out in St. Pete. Yankees 7, Rays 7, bottom 10. If you missed the end of this game, wow. Down 7-0. The Rays got six in the game, three on the Evan Longoria home run. And then down to their last strike, Dan Johnson hits a two-out, pinch hit, bottom nine home run. That tied it. And that's where we are right now, 7-7, bottom 10. John Crux, Steve Berthiaume along the way.
And the excitement builds for Tampa. They got their power up. B.J. Upton the leadoff. Evan Longoria, you mentioned, hit the big three-run homer in the eighth inning. Following him, Scott Proctor susceptible to the home run ball, so this could be an exciting inning for the Yankees and the Rays.
B.J. Upton will lead off the Tampa 10th. Strike going one. We mentioned he has, he's 0-for-3 tonight, but he has flourished, hitting second in the order for Joe Maddon. 373 in his last 22 games. 14 RBI, 16 walks. He has reached base safely in 21 of those 22 games. And boy, if they can get him on here, he'd be the winning run with nobody out. Rays fans taking a page from the Yankee fan playbook here, and the B.J. Upton chant has started at the Trop.
Nice to see.
It sure is. 2-1 to Upton. 3-1. Scott Proctor, the 11th Yankee pitcher to work this evening. That's right, 11. It has been a parade of Yankee pitchers. No one currently warming up. Upton, ball four. Leadoff man on here, home half of the 10th, and here comes Evan Longoria. And as we just showed you, it was Longo's big three-run home run of the eighth inning that made it a game again.
Really was, but here's decision time for the Tampa Bay Rays. Do you send B.J. Upton, who's already got a stolen base in this game? Do you send him? You know they're going to walk him because who's hit behind him? Who knows?
Right now, it's Jose Lobaton, the catcher.
Exactly. That's what I mean. Now, if Upton steals, you walk him. What do you do with Lobaton? You bunt him? You bunt him, then you walk Johnny Damon to load the bases. So if I'm Upton, I might stay put for a couple strikes. If Longoria gets two strikes on him, then maybe take off. But I'm giving Longoria a couple chances right here to win this game.
He's ahead in the count 1-0. There's Lobaton, the on-deck hitter. Nobody out here. Bottom 10, 7-7. Upton on first. He's back.
But the bases loaded and Ben Zobrist up isn't a bad situation either if Upton steals and they walk Longoria. So, you know, Joe Maddon has to play it the way he's played it all year. And I think if Upton thinks he can get it, I think Upton's going to go. Not necessarily what I would do, but I think, you know, that this is the way Joe Maddon's done it.
And there is a big red-colored scoreboard in the corner of left field here at Tropicana Field. Joe Maddon admitted he'd be watching that all night. Right now it reads Red Sox 3, Orioles 2. So they are very much aware of the situation in Baltimore. There it is. Red Sox, Orioles 3-2. They had a long rain delay. They are back going again in Baltimore. Dave Martinez, Joe Maddon looking on. Evan Longoria. 1-1 here against Scott Proctor.
I think right here would be a good time to pitch out because you don't care if you walk Longoria if Upton steals, but if you can pitch out and get him.
Upton again not running. Longoria fouls it off.
Wow. A pretty healthy hack at that one. Well, now two strikes if you're Upton. You think, okay, if they're going to pitch out, this is probably the pitcher going to do it. But if they're going to try to get Longoria out, they're going to try to get him out with a breaking ball away, this might be a chance for Upton to take off.
Longoria, including tonight, 19 home runs since the All-Star break, 12 home runs in his last 40 games. His three-run shot in the eighth made it a game again. They got six in the eighth, one in the ninth. Misses, 2-2. Since June 20th, Evan Longoria leads the major league 79 RBIs in 89 games. Upton back safely.
Amazing how when the visiting pitcher throws over a couple times, they blew. But when Farnsworth threw over seven times,
it was a good strategy then.
He's got something going on. They have a play on.
Upton leads at first, stays put. Longoria swings, fly ball center field. Gardner is there. Take a look, rookie.
Well, you can't hit him out every time, but this is that's a fastball up and away. That's a tough pitch. I mean, you have to be dialed into it. Remember the last swing he had was a fastball in that he tried. He got real quick on it, tried to hook it. That one's away, so he's already committed in a little bit, it seemed like. And then when you reach for it, you lose all your power, and that's why that ball stayed in the ballpark.
All right, now it is. How does the fact that Jose Lobaton is now the hitter change what you may do with Upton at first base?
Well, now he's go.
He's got the green light right here.
If he thinks he has a jump, if he thinks he can get a jump, he goes any pitch in this count. And don't be surprised if Lobaton don't hit one in a gap somewhere either. I mean, it's just Tampa Bay Rays baseball, isn't it?
Well, they've come from 9 games back in the wild card and 7 runs down today.
You had a guy hit a big 3-run home run in the game last night, Matt Joyce hitting 4th in the lineup. You pinch hit for him, what, the 5th inning?
Yep. Remarkable.
So, yeah, Lobaton will probably hit a gapper right here.
Upton stays put. Lobaton swings, foul back. Johnny Damon, the on-deck hitter for Tampa Bay. Upton at first. He's the winning run.
We're gonna boo. How dare you throw over?
Now, you played first base. Did that drive you crazy when you were out there playing first base?
When the people booed?
Yeah.
No, not really.
Right.
I thought it was kind of dumb, but I think a lot of things that happen on a baseball field can be dumb at times.
The 0-1 to Jose Lobaton. Not so much.
Pretty good pick right there by Laird.
Brandon Laird started the game at third base. He has moved over to first, and here's another look.
And there's a lot of room down there, and that ball gets past. You see the pick. That's a tough pick, too, because that was into the runner's glove, was almost in Upton's hip. That ball gets past him. Upton might be on third base.
Upton,
and then the fun begins. We'll pitch to him. We'll walk him. We'll try to pitch to him, and then we'll walk this guy. Love strategy, Steve.
Upton stays. Lobaton foul back. Well, if it's the automatic green light, so far it's more of a yellow light over there.
Well, Proctor's doing a great job of throwing over, holding the ball, going quick, you know, slide stepping, but, you know, going quick with his hands. You know, once he comes set, he's going right to home. Other times he's holding it. It's tough to get it. He hasn't had a pattern yet of how long he holds the ball, and you get a count on it. A lot of guys you can count, they go bump, bump, bump. As soon as they come set, it's bump, 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 and you can go. They won't even throw over.
Proctor ahead here, 0-2. Upton stays put. Lobaton looks at strike 3.
Thank you.
Johnny Damon, 1-for-3. Has singled, has been hit by a pitch, and has scored a run. The Rays trailed 7-0, 6 in the 8th, 1 in the 9th. Upton at first, he's the winning run with 2 outs. How about a pitch sort of down and in, one of those that Johnny Damon just turns on and pulls down the right field line?
He's looking for it.
That might have been it.
Yeah, his timing is off tonight. I mean, he's been so far ahead of pitches, hitting him so far foul, which is, Johnny Damon will get out in front and hit balls foul, but not as far foul as he's hit some tonight. And then you see his base hit even. He reached for it. He was out in front and hit it off the end of the bat and hit a little blooper, but, you know, his timing is off. But the thing is, he's a veteran, and all it takes is maybe one pitch.
He's behind here, 0-1. Changeup. Still nothing from Upton over there at first base. That might have been the good pitch to go on there.
Yeah, anytime a slow breaking ball, but you see Johnny Damon right there. I mean, the leg kick and everything else, he's ahead of the fastball. When you're ahead of the fastball, there's a really good chance you're going to be way ahead of the off-speed pitches, and right there is a perfect example.
Proctor a strike away from getting out of this thing. Up and back. Johnny Damon has one hit tonight, one more here, and he would tie a new Hall of Famer, Roberto Alomar, for 56th on baseball's all-time list. This would be a good spot for it. Passed Lou Gehrig last night. Rocky, Johnny Damon looks like he's got a few more years left in him, too, as you look at Ben Zobrist, the on-deck hitter for the Rays.
Yeah, good role for him here in Tampa. You know, living at home, of course, being at home, it's always nice as a player at the end of your career. But, you know, the fact that he DHs and he's not playing the outfield every day.
Upton stays put. Damon fouls it off down the left side.
I got a feeling this at bat ain't over. I think Johnny Damon's going to throw a battle on Scott Proctor right here. He knows what's at stake, and you know, he missed an opportunity. He got on base, but you know, he's had an opportunity to do some damage early in the game and didn't get it done. I just think that this is where Johnny Damon excels.
Upton leads at first. 1-2 to Damon. There goes Upton. Damon swings. Fly ball right field. Foul. That's what he does. He just turns on those pitches and sends them down that line. Sometimes they hook, sometimes they don't. Here it is.
Well, this is the breaking ball that he missed by a mile and a half a couple pitches ago to get to the second strike. And he's still out in front of him. You can see he's starting to time it a little bit better. And I'm Scott Proctor. I might stay away from that pitch and either try to come hard in on him and see if he'll hit another one foul or swing through it or get jammed and hit a grounder to first base. But I don't think I'm throwing that breaking ball again.
Swing and a miss.
And he did and struck him out.
Scott Proctor wiggles off the hook. We will go top 11 now. The Rays and the Yankees are tied 7-7 here at the Trop with Tampa Bay's season on the line. What else is going on? Let's get a Baseball Tonight update from Carl Ravage.
Hi, Steve, with Bobby Valentine. Wild one here. Crawford up with a man on first and moving, and he hits a shot to the gap in left center. Scudero hesitated, and then you have a play at the plate.
Yeah, he has to be on the third base side of second base here, and Timmy Bogaerts sends him. It's a bang-bang play, but it would have been second and third and one out. They'd like to have that one back and get an add-on run.
Orioles coming up, 3-2, bottom eight, Daniel Bard on.
Steve Berthume, John Kruk back with you on ESPN's Wednesday Night Baseball. Top 11 here at the Trop in St. Pete. The Rays and the Yankees are tied up 7-7. And we have a new pitcher on there for Tampa Bay, the 27-year-old right-hander. It's Brandon Gomes. He will face Eduardo Nunez, Brandon Lehr, then the top of the order, Ramiro Pena. If you're just joining us, you've missed a lot. It was 7-0 Yankees. The Rays had only two hits. Their season appeared dead in the water. But then Evan Longoria hit a three-run home run as part of a six-run Tampa Bay eighth. Dan Johnson hit a pinch-hit two-out home run bottom nine to send us to extras. And here we are, top 11, 7-7. Keeping a close eye on the score. It's in bright red over there in the left field corner here at Tropicana Field. The Red Sox, there it is, lead the Orioles 3-2, bottom eight. As we just saw in Carl Ravitch's update, Tim Bogar had another runner thrown out at home plate for Boston. In terms of the National League, you see a top right there on your screen. Phillies and Braves tied up 3-3. They're in extra innings as well. The Cardinals have already won at Houston. And, well, you don't think they're watching that game intently. 2-1 to Nunez. Straight over home plate. Lobatone might have a play. Not so much.
Hey, usually it's 45 minutes after the game when you're on the road that the bus leaves. But I don't think the Cardinals are going anywhere because they don't know where they're going.
There it is, St. Louis 8, Houston nothing. Chris Carpenter was their starter today. There's the Philly score, 3-3 in extras.
Think about being the traveling secretary for the Cardinals.
No thanks.
You're in Houston, correct?
Correct.
Where do you go tonight? We're either going to St. Louis.
I think I go to the bar.
We're going to Atlanta, or we're going home to rest before we go to
Philadelphia.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, that's what I would do. Well, we had that situation yesterday, didn't we?
There were some emails exchanged, yeah. If this, if not that.
But we're here, and it's a great game.
This has been an absolute blast.
We have no idea who half the players are in the game
anymore. It has become a spring training game.
It's still exciting. I mean, who'd have thought a guy with 35 innings would be pitching the 11th inning of a tie game when your season's on the line?
Nunez goes down and gets that one. Might drop in front, and it's right there. Upton has it. One away. All right, so here's Brandon Laird now. He started at third base. He was a late addition into the Yankee lineup. Alex Rodriguez was originally set to play third base. He was scratched about 20 minutes before game time. Laird came in and played third. At some point when it was 7-0, they pinch hit for Teixeira. Who, oh, by the way, hit two home runs tonight, including a grand slam. How long ago does that seem? And so Laird was moved over to first base.
That was the first game of the doubleheader.
Yeah, exactly. Strike, 0-1.
Well, and the reason why Teixeira hit the grand slam, because Laird got a base hit and was on base for that grand slam. So it's not like he's not capable.
One for four, single, and he scored a run. Brandon Gomes, the pitcher for the Rays. Jennings is there, two outs.
So there's some closing speed there on those two guys, Upton and Desmond Jennings. You think pitchers don't enjoy that?
We saw Jennings last week make a web gem where he went the other way, went to the gap in left center.
He took one away from Jeter in a diving play on that turf surface out there and on the warning track, and that's another great play, because as you slide, if something happens, he misses that ball. Not sure Laird would get a triple out of it. There's a chance, but you're putting a runner in scoring position. You're taking the double play out of order, but you know what? That's the way these guys play baseball. They play reckless abandon. They run when they shouldn't. They do things that they shouldn't do, but you know, here they are with a chance to go to the postseason.
Ramiro Pena fouled back. We mentioned the Jennings play. This was Monday. Now this time, Johnny's going the other way.
Well, and this is big too, because this is a tie game, and Jeter, this is a leadoff. Jeter was leading off the inning right there, and that's just an unbelievable play. You don't think the pitcher doesn't love that? I mean, James Shields was applauding after that play from the pitcher's mound, and well, he should. He kept the double off the board.
0-1 to Pena. Ooh, Joe West gets him the strike in the outer half. It's 0-2. Strike zone just get a bit bigger there.
Well, Joe might have finally missed one, but you know, give him credit. I mean, it's not like he hadn't seen a bunch of pitches.
He's done an absolutely terrific job, no joke. They're on their feet here. 0-2, two outs. Gomes to Pena. foul.
You know, Steve.
Yes, sir.
Umpires will ask a catcher when they bring in all these young pitchers, any young pitcher, hey, what's he throw? Does he have a trick pitch? Does he throw a split? Does he, you know, what's he, does he throw a cutter? Does he throw a two-seamer? What's he, and the catcher will say, hey, you know, you might want to stay with his two-seamer, breaks later, whatever. But they want to get a scouting report on these young pitchers, too. Joe West hasn't had that luxury. They've been a new pitcher in every inning.
And they've had young catchers, Montero and Romine, behind the plate for the Yankees. Here's the 0-2. Pena now playing second base. He is in the leadoff spot in what's become, to say the least, a patchwork Yankee lineup. A lot of crossouts here on the old scorecard. Golson is on deck. Yeah, you gave up about the sixth, I think.
Yeah, it just got confusing.
Yeah, I don't blame you. Take a look. Joe West, I think, has to thank Lobatone for that one. That one's headed right to his knee.
Yeah, that would have hit him right in the kneecap. Of course, with the shin guard on it, it would have still hurt really bad. But, yeah, I mean, that's a great play. Sitting up way outside and being able to reach back and get that one.
They're on their feet looking for one more strike. He may be crossing Lobatone up. The previous pitch looked like...
Well, he's not crossing him up. He's just missing location
just
so poorly. Yeah, I mean, Lobatone's setting up, you know, 6 inches off the plate, and he threw it, you know, 6 inches off the plate on the inside. So, yeah, I mean, that's tough to do. Whatever his best pitch is, he better throw it here.
Foul. Phillies have taken a 4-3 lead, John Kruk, in Atlanta. And if that happens, the Cardinals have already won in Houston. St. Louis would win the National League Wild Card. If that score right there holds, 4-3. Red Sox lead 3-2. They're in the ninth in Baltimore. Two and two, two outs to Ramiro Pena. Swing and a miss.
I can't let allergies.
Fast relief. Love it. Or get your money back.
This season of Tampa Bay Rays comebacks continues. They lost 8 of their first 9 by the All-Star break. They were 3rd in the ALE. September 2nd, they were 9 back in the wild card. Since then, Tampa Bay has gone 16-8. They were 7 runs down tonight. They got 6 in the 8th. One big 2-out pinch hit home run in the 9th. And here we are. It was 7-0. It's now 7-7. Dan Johnson, bottom 9, 2-out, a pinch hit home run that went down the right field line. And here we are, the Rays, another chance to win this. We're bottom 11 at the Trop in St. Pete. Yankees and Rays all tied up. Steve Berthume, John Kruk at ESPN's Wednesday Night Baseball.
And how exciting is it?
Ben Zobrist will lead off the Rays 11th. Ball one. Ben Zobrist hit a home run early in last night's game. The big home run was the 3-run shot by Matt Joyce. Zobrist got them started with this one.
Well, he has that ability, and he can get out in front of one and whip one over that right field fence.
And Zobrist has been on a home run tear lately, coming into tonight. 4 homers in his last 6 games, 5 in his last 10. In fact, before the start of tonight's game, 5 of his previous 9 hits had been home runs.
Like to see one dialed in here, wouldn't he?
That would be a pretty cool way to finish this thing off.
Well, you know, it's not going to be the usual, a little single here and there, you know, Something special.
Ooh, way out in front of the change there.
A lot of times in these extra inning games, everyone wants to be a hero and hit that big walk-off homer. And you see a lot of bad swings, a lot of hitters being out in front of pitches because they're looking to pull something.
See all the Yankee veterans there on the top step of the dugout. They may be done for the night, most of them, but they're certainly anxious spectators.
Yeah, you can see.
Posada, Cano, A-Rod, who was a late scratch, as we mentioned earlier. Red Sox lead the Orioles 3-2. Rays and Yankees tied up here 7-7. And now Proctor, John Crump, seems to be struggling. Gone full here to Ben Zobrist to lead off the 11th.
Well, you wonder how many times this season he's been extended into his third inning of work.
Well, he's been the take one for the team guy.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that was before all the arm problems he's had. So, this, you know, again, there's no one down there warming up. So this is his game.
Zobrist looks at ball four. The Rays have the leadoff man on here. Zobrist is the winning run at first with nobody out. Scott Proctor is the 11th Yankee pitcher of the night. The first seven gave up one hit in 7 2/3. The latter four have given up seven runs on six hits in 3 1/3. And now the leadoff man is on here. Casey Kochman, the Rays hitter. Austin Romine out to have a conversation with Proctor. Scott Proctor has gone three innings once this year already. Did it for the Braves back in July. Here he is as a Yankee, and he's behind 1-0 to Casey Kochman. Anything on here for Joe Maddon?
Well, yeah, you're hoping that Casey Kochman gets out in front of one and rolls one over in that hole between first and second. He can develop a first and third situation with Zobrist. And that's not Kochman's strength, but when he does hit the ball to right field, most of the time it is a pull grounder.
Brandon Guyer has come out on the on-deck circle for Tampa Bay.
And if I'm Kochman, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking to get out in front of someone and hook something in that hole.
The 1-0. Kochman swings.
Not that one.
Fly ball left field. Goldson is under it. One out.
Yeah, that's the last thing you wanted right there. I mean, if that's a pitch you can't pull, then you take it because, you know, it's only the first strike. You know, and that was one of those. And look, his strength is hitting the ball the other way on a line. But that's a pitch right there that you have no chance of moving the runner first to third. All you can do, you hope you can do, is hit it down the line for a double. But that's highly unlikely with a pitch up in the zone like that to a lefty. So, you know, you can take that pitch. If it's a strike, great. 1-1, I still can work that hole. You know, give Proctor credit, though. He pitched him hard away and didn't give him an opportunity to pull the ball.
Here's Brandon Guyer, 7-7, bottom 11. Guyer's got some pop. Hit a big home run in his first ever at bat. Not a bad way to start. Be a pretty good way to finish here.
Surely would be. If you're a Rays fan.
Well.
If you're a Red Sox fan, no. Yankee fan, no. But
swing and a miss there. I just look at it in terms of an exciting game.
Well, some people think that the longer it goes, the more the excitement builds.
Builds or wanes, depending on your point of view. Guyer was the third player in Rays history to home run his first major league at bat, following Esteban Yan and Elijah Dukes.
I got nothing to do till 6:30 in the morning.
What's at 6:30?
Mike and Mike.
That's over the phone, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Those guys get up awfully early, I've noticed. Yeah. 1-2 to Guyer. Zobrist is back. He's the winning run on first base. Would you at some point have thought about a bunt here?
Well, you have so many. you have so many young players coming up behind Kochman that you know, and Kochman's hitting over 300. So sure. You want to take the bat out of his hand and leave it up to young players.
Guyer swings. It gets through Nunez. Zober stays at second. And now the Rays have the winning run in scoring position with one out here in the 11th. Brandon Guyer comes up and laces one into center field. John Kruk, here's the swing from Guyer against Proctor.
Well, he tried to hit a home run his first pitch, first swing he took, but that one there, he more stays inside of it better. And just, you know, he didn't try to do too much. Just take what this pitcher's giving you. And, you know, look, if they bunted right there, they're not playing. Nunez isn't playing double play depth, so that ball might get caught. But, you know, Joe Maddon rolled the dice with his veteran and Casey Kochman, who's hit well for him all season. And, no, but you got to basically the same situation. Now you got first and second.
A quick trainer visit with Joe Girardi out to the mound to check on Proctor. He's fine. And here we are. First and second, one out for Joe Maddon's Rays.
And that conversation went this way. Hey, Scott, how you doing? Look down in the bullpen. We ain't got nothing left.
It's all you.
Yeah.
Here's Sean Rodriguez, the nine-hole hitter for Tampa Bay.
So how do you feel now?
Base hit wins it for the Rays. Ball one. There you see the Red Sox score. They lead 3-2 in the ninth inning in Baltimore. Rodriguez swings, foul back. There's your winning run. It's Ben Zobrist. He's on second base.
And a good arm in left field, Mandry Jones. Brett Gardner, not a strong arm, but an accurate arm.
The 1-1 to Rodriguez misses high, 2-1.
The key, if you're Ben Zobrist, is getting a great secondary lead and reading the ball off the bat with only one out. Last thing you want to do is to hesitate and have to have Tom Foley, the third base coach, have to hold you up. You want to be aggressive here, but make the right read.
Hitters count for Rodriguez. Takes 3-1. Desmond Jennings is the on-deck hitter. He's the leadoff man for the Rays. There's Jennings. Upton hits behind him. Two on, one out, 7-7, bottom 11. Rodriguez, third base. Chavez gets the force at third. And it's going to be up to Jennings here with two outs.
Wow. There, Chavez, former Gold Glove winner. That ball ate him up. Sean Rodriguez hits an absolute seed at him. But that's a veteran. No panic. Take your time. Pick it up. You know you're only going to get one out. Step on the base and live to see another hitter. A lot of young players are trying to rush that with their glove and stab at it a couple times. And Zobrist runs past him. And then the nerves start. Now you have a bases loaded, one out. Instead, the veteran says, okay, I'll get my one and let Proctor work on Desmond Jennings.
Jennings takes a strike. So now it's Guyer on second, Rodriguez on first. Here in the Tampa Bay 11. There are the base runners for the Rays. Scott Proctor needs one more out. He's ahead 0-1. Popped up. Pena has it, and Proctor is off the hook. The Rays strand two will go top 12. Joe Maddon's team was down 7-0. It's now 7-7, headed to the 12th here at the trough.
Creating a business website is easy. Whether you're a lawyer, a photographer, or a beauty salon, choose your type of business, company name, color scheme, and design. Done. Customize your site with your own text, pictures, and logo. Customers will find you everywhere. Choose from over 200 industries. 1&1 My Website. Try it now for free. 1&1.com.
Brandon Gomes on to pitch for the Rays here to face the Yankees top 12 at Tropicana Field in St. Petersburg. Steve Berthume, John Kruk with you on ESPN's Wednesday Night Baseball, and game 162 has not disappointed. The Rays were down 7-0. They got 6 in the 8th, led by a 3-run Evan Longoria home run. They got one big one in the 9th. Dan Johnson, a 2-out pinch hit home run that tied it. And here we are now. Top 12. And Greg Golson will lead it off for the Yankees. It'll be Golson, Chavez, and Posada, who's in there as the DH. Strike going one. Brandon Gomes, 27-year-old right-hander, the pride of Fall River, Massachusetts, or as they say there, Fall River. And he may have a half an eye on the Red Sox team right now. They've gone bottom 9 in Baltimore. It's 3-2 Boston. Here's the 0-1 to Golson. Swing and a miss.
Very unorthodox delivery by Gomes. He kind of throws his hands at you and then comes a little three-quarter, like sort of like Jake Peavy's arm angle. But when you throw a slider from there and a fastball that runs, it makes it difficult to pick it up and difficult to stay on.
He's ahead 0-2 here. Ball one. The Yankees have had wholesale substitutions. They were up 7-0, so they started bringing in the irregulars, I guess, Joe Girardi. And it's Pena, Golson, Chavez, Posada, Dickerson, Gardner, Romine, Nunez, Laird right now for the Yankees. Longoria. Golson's aboard to lead off the Yankee 12. We have two relievers up now in the Tampa Bay bullpen.
James Shields is the righty.
Jake McGee and big game James. We should call him this year complete game James Shields. And they're going to make the move right now. Joe Maddon wants a pitching change. We'll look at the left-hander Jake McGee when we come back. The Yankees have the lead man on here in the 12th, tied up 7-7.
Break. Just the right moment.
Steve Berthume, John Kruk back with you on ESPN's Wednesday Night Baseball. We are top 12 at the trough. Yankees and Rays tied up 7-7. Greg Golson, the leadoff man on here in the Yankee 12. And here is the new pitcher for Tampa Bay. It's the lefty Jake McGee. He has had very mixed results as of late. In 8 of his last 15 appearances, he's allowed at least one run. He's got a 6.39 ERA with 12 hits and 4 walks allowed during that span. So it's something of a mixed bag here from Jake McGee.
Well, he has the arm, and that's the thing that Joe Maddon wants right now with the runner on first base. Eric Chavez is a pull hitter. You don't want him hitting that ball in the hole. McGee, with his velocity and the fact that it's lefty against lefty, makes it a little tougher for Chavez to pull it. But Chavez is a veteran. He'll get it started early enough.
They throw over to keep Golson close. And in the meantime, another developing storyline here is the fact that James Shields continues to warm up in the Rays bullpen. And he just pitched 8 2/3 innings the other night. McGee to Chavez. Swing and a miss. Chavez hitting the 3-hole right now for Joe Girardi's lineup. Posada on deck. He's the DH. So 1-2. Golson running on the pitch. Chavez drops it in. Golson goes into third, and the Yankees have first and third here. Nobody out. Big hit there for Eric Chavez, and now Posada comes up for the Yankees.
A huge hit. Not anything pretty by Chavez, but very effective, especially with Golson running on the play. The last thing you want to do is to strike him out, throw him out. But, you know, Chavez swung through a couple fastballs. He gets one there, middle in. And look, he would love to have pulled it in the hole to get first to third, but putting it in play and making something happen is equally as important. And with Golson running, easily getting to third base. And now the Rays have a little tough situation.
Let's see where they play the infield. It's in on the edge of the grass here for Joe Maddon. First and third, no one out for Posada. Fouled back. Crucky, look at the way they're set up here. They're sort of in, I guess. Well,
yeah. If a ball's hit at them, they can still come home with the ball with Golson. You know, the last thing they're thinking right now is double play because they don't want to risk it.
Right.
You know, but right now you want to get an out and figure out a way to keep the double play in order because you have Dickerson up next, who's a lefty. So you know, you would hope that McGee can get him out and make a two-out hit beat you, but yeah, you have to cut this run off. You can't play for a double play and hope to win this.
Red Sox one out away in the ninth. They lead at the Orioles 3-2. The 1-1. Posada swings, ground ball, third base. Longoria has a play at third. Golson's out. Evan Longoria can play some defense, and we just saw some there.
He surely can, but Golson right there just made it just a poor mistake. If you're going on contact, then you go. If you're not going on contact, then you go back to the base because, like I said, they're not going to try to turn a double play, even though Jorge Posada's a slow runner. But when you get caught out there in no man's land, try to get in a rundown. Possibly Chavez can go from first to third while you're in that rundown. Instead, he just let Longoria tag him. Now you have first and second. It's going to take at least a single to score Chavez, but now the double play's in order, and you can play back now. You don't have to play in anymore.
Here's Chris Dickerson, one out, first and second, 7-7, top 12. Here's another look. You're saying the last thing he can do here, if you're Golson, is stop.
Is to stop and let Longoria tag him like this. Right there, you know, okay, I can't get back. Now I got to go. I'll get in a rundown. I'll do something. Maybe Chavez can get to third, maybe not. But you have to give the team that opportunity. He just let Longoria tag him. Now, you got not good speed at second, and you got no speed at first base.
Dickerson looks at a strike. He's down 0-2.
I mean, you're on third base with no outs. You stay there because you're the fast guy. You can score on a shallow fly ball to the outfield, possibly. No, Chavez right now might not score on a single to the outfield.
You've got some slow runners out there, as you mentioned. There's Posada on first, and Chavez, he's the go-ahead run at second with one out here. Dickerson in an 0-2 hole. Got him. Couple of looks now. Jake McGee here.
Well, that's just a nasty fastball, especially with two strikes. You got to try to protect. Dickerson was doing everything he can to try to, okay, I don't want to swing because I don't think it's a strike, but it's close enough. I hope I can just put it in play and hopefully foul it off and live to see another pitch, but couldn't sniff that one.
Brett Gardner steps in.
Again, this is the same situation. You got a runner on second base. You got to cheat in because Gardner's not a big power guy. You got to cheat in left field and center.
Looks at a strike on one.
And if I'm Evan Longoria, you see him backing up now a couple steps right there. I'm backing up. If Brett Gardner wants to bunt with two strikes, you know what? Have at it. But I'm not going to let you hit a chopper over my head from playing in. Move back. Make him hit it over your head on a line or hit it past you on a line.
As you'll note, we have been running the scores from the other critical games from tonight up in the top right corner of your screen. There you see the Red Sox. They have the Orioles down to their last out, 3-2 in the ninth inning. The National League is over. The Cardinals have won 8-0 at Houston. The Braves lost to Philadelphia. So the Cardinals have won the National League Wild Card. American League Wild Card still very much undecided. But if the Red Sox score holds, the Rays must win this game. Gardner looks at a ball. Austin Roman is the on-deck hitter for the Yankees. Misses 3-1.
Now, Joe Maddon, going to be interesting to see if he brings in James Shields to face Austin Roman, the right-handed hitter. Or do you take a chance with McGee, who can walk people? Keep him in the game with the bases loaded. I think if Brett Gardner gets on base without a run scored, I think James Shields is coming in this game.
Here's the 3-1 to Gardner. Swung on. Zobrist. The Rays dodge a huge bullet there and will go bottom 12. 7-7. The wild card hope still alive here in St. Pete. Here at Tropicana Field, where we had a two-out, bottom of the ninth inning home run, they just got one in Baltimore. The Orioles, down to their last out, have tied the Red Sox 3-3 at Camden Yards. The score was just posted here at the Trop, and everyone noticed. Nolan Reimel has tied it for the Orioles. A two-out, ninth inning home run. Pardon me, double. Not a home run, a double. 3-3, Red Sox and Orioles. Nolan Reimel doubles in the tying run with two outs. The Rays looking for some drama here. Home half of the 12th at the Trop. And it'll be Upton, Longoria, and Lobatone to face the Yankees' Scott Proctor. Proctor may pitch a complete game out there all by himself.
He might go nine, yes. But here's the advantage, the offense. A lot of times you see a reliever, you see him once, you won't see him again for another 2 or 3 weeks, maybe even a month. They've seen Proctor now for the going through the second time, so this might be an interesting inning for the Rays.
Here's Upton down 0-1. So the Red Sox were one out away from winning in Baltimore. That game's not over yet, but it's 3-3 now. And of course, if the Red Sox lose there, the Rays could still lose this game and host the AL Wild Card playoff here tomorrow afternoon. Or what is now this afternoon here, as we just went after midnight on the East Coast there, John Crow.
We did?
Yeah, it's past your bedtime.
It is.
Steve Berthume, John Crow with you. It's Wednesday Night Baseball. What a game it's been here at the Trop in St. Pete. Upton takes a big swing and a miss. The Baltimore Orioles have just beaten the Boston Red Sox. That game has just gone final. Orioles 4, Red Sox 3. Baltimore trailed 3-2 in the ninth. They win it 4-3. We're waiting to see that up there. And once it's official up there, they will go bonkers here at the Trop.
Not that there's an advantage of playing extra innings, but if that game is over and the Rays know it, you think James Shields is coming in this game? No way.
Now, B.J. Upton in there waves off Joe West, and Joe calls time.
Well, the Rays players are clapping like they know something, so apparently that is true, that the Baltimore Orioles beat the Red Sox, and I guarantee it, James Shields is back in the clubhouse somewhere.
Upton swings, and there's one away. Well, everybody has a cell phone and a smartphone and the whole thing, and in these days of social media and whatnot, everybody knows before it's officially posted on the board. The board here still says Red Sox 3, Orioles 3. I'm not sure that anyone here completely trusts their phones until they see it up on the big red board. And it's funny how that game is highlighted in red here at the left field corner. It very much stands out at Tropicana Field. There it is. Still 3-3, two outs in the ninth. Evan Longoria, one out in the 12th. Ball one. It was Longoria who hit the big three-run home run as part of that six-run Tampa Bay eighth. They were down 7-0. They made it 7-6 Johnson tied it in the ninth with a pinch hit home run. And that's how we got here. 7-7, bottom 12. Longoria looks at a strike, 1-1. It is official. It just went up, and you can hear the roar. There's Longoria's three-run home run in the eighth. That was a big jolt of energy here for these fans at the Trop. And there it is. Final, Orioles 4, Red Sox 3. Boston has lost. If Tampa Bay can win this game, they will win the American League wild card. Thank you, Sean. Steve Berthiaume, John Crook, here with you on Wednesday Night Baseball, Tropicana Field, Evan Longoria. Even 2-2. The Rays trailed the Yankees 7-0. They got a six-run eighth inning led by the batter here, Longoria. A big three-run home run that made it 7-6. There were two outs in the ninth. Dan Johnson hit a pinch-hit home run to tie it, and here we are. Longoria fouled away. The Yankees led 7-0 for most of the game. Mark Teixeira hit an early grand slam. Teixeira followed later with a solo shot. The Yankees were up 7-0. Then Joe Girardi put in his irregular lineup, and most of the Yankee regulars now watching from the dugout here, and it's a patchwork Yankee group out there for Joe Girardi as we have reached the 12th inning here. Longoria up there 2-2 against Scott Proctor. Longoria, line drive, left field. Win. The Tampa Bay Rays have won the American League wild card. Evan Longoria's second home run of the night wins the wild card for the Rays. John Kruk, his second of the night, wins the wild card for Tampa Bay.
Didn't know if it was going to be high enough. Didn't know if it was going to be far enough. It just sneaks over that 316 sign right there in left field. The lowest part of the fence, 315, gets over, and euphoria. Think about the last 2 minutes in Rays history. The Red Sox lose in the bottom of the ninth. Two runs by the Baltimore Orioles, and within minutes, Evan Longoria hits a game-winning home run to send them into the postseason. Unbelievable.
They were down by 9 games the first week of September. They were down by 7 runs here tonight. They were down to their last out in the ninth inning.
and they've come back and won the wild card.
Well, that just tells you one thing. One team wanted it, the other team didn't know how to get it. And the Tampa Bay Rays, they wanted this thing so badly, as Boston did. One team, though, they knew how to finish. The other team had no clue how to get it done in September. That's a sad thing in Boston, but you know what? They don't deserve to be there. The Tampa Bay Rays do.
It was Longoria's three-run home run. That was the big part of the Tampa Bay six-run eighth inning. They were down 7-0. They got within 7-6. Dan Johnson hit a two-out pinch-hit home run bottom nine that tied it at 7, and Longoria here has won it in the 12th. And we had some fans that left. Most stayed, and boy, are they glad they did.
Well, we had them written. I had them written off after the Teixeira Grand Slam, and then lo and behold, they surprised us again.
They've been doing it all year long, 9 games back. After the games of September 2nd, they managed to tie the Red Sox for the wild card in the final week. They were down 7-0 here. 6-8, 1-9, and one very big one in the 12th. We wouldn't be here without Dan Johnson, who hit a big, big two-out pinch-hit home run in the ninth inning. Dan, Steve, Berthume, and John Krug with you. Tell us about your at-bat.
You know, it kind of sprung up on me. You know, I was up in the cage, and one of the security guys ran up and said, "Hey, you're hitting." So I ran back down, and, you know, I was just trying to get a good pitch to hit, and it ended up ending well for me.
Isn't that what happened to Kirk Gibson in 88? "Hey, you're hitting. Get in there."
I don't know if it was the same thing, but, you know, I just so fortunate to be able to get that chance and then capitalize on it.
Dan, how was this team able to come from 9 games back and 7 runs down?
Oh, man. If you have the formula, I'd love to know it. It'd make you a lot of money. You know, this team is just grinders. I mean, all we do is go out there and try to win every night. And, you know, it was one of those things that we just got the opportunity and we did it.
What was the mood in the dugout when it was clear that David Price was struggling early and you were in that quick 7-0 hole?
You know, it was one of those things where we just kept grinding it out again. And, you know, we knew we needed a big inning. And, you know, when it started off, was it the eighth, I believe, that we started off getting the runners on and then the big hit by pitch. I think that really turned everybody around. And then Longo coming up with that big home run again. Just enough to give us a chance.
Dan, thanks very much. Congratulations. We'll see you in the postseason.
You bet. All right. Thank you.
What a night here at Tropicana Field in St. Petersburg. The fans are not leaving, John Krug. Well, why should they?
They shouldn't. It's time to party. And I know it's a Wednesday night, but you know what? Hey, it ends in a Y, don't it? So let's go have fun.
They're having a ball down there on the field. The Tampa Bay Rays, they have watched this team come back all month long, all night long. And when that score went up from Baltimore, the fact that the Orioles had come back to tie and then beat the Red Sox, there was that just injection of optimism, and suddenly it was all set, and Longoria came through with all the pieces in place.
And you hear so many players say something about, you know, we don't want help. You know, we want to do it ourselves. Well, the Rays needed help from Boston. They got it because Boston is awful in the month of September.
And now they take this postseason enthusiasm into the wild card. What do you expect from them after here?
I think they're going to carry. They say maybe a little hangover, maybe a little, you know, little letdown. But I don't think so with this team. I don't think Joe Maddon will allow it.
Perhaps the most dramatic night in the history of the Tampa Bay Rays franchise. The Rays down 7-0 on the season's final day. Come back and beat the Yankees 8-7. Evan Longoria wins the wild card with a walk-off home run. What a night at the Trop. Coming up next, it's SportsCenter. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For John Krug, I'm Steve Berthume. So long from St. Pete.
SportsCenter Telecast is brought to you in high definition by Vizio.
This is SportsCenter.
What's good? SportsCenter on the ones and twos. Stuart, Scott, Van Pelt. What were we saying sitting here in the set before?